You can try at home. It was used to help with the sleep. If they would do a dried oregano pillow and you would sleep on it, so to help with sleep and stress. And also, this is quite interesting. Oregano is used in most anti-cellulite creams and herbal remedies, and you can do one at home. So if you take 100 grams of almond oil and 10 grams of oregano oil and you mix it together, because it improves circulation, so that's why it's used in anti-cellulite creams as well. So that's something that you might want to, yeah, the ones of you that want to try. In terms of benefits, it's full of phenolic acid, and it's, again, another antibacterial, antifungal, antiviral. These are, you know, great things that you can use every day, and they have all these properties, so I think it's quite good to know. So some of the bacteria that have been, you know, they were not totally cured, but, you know, they were reduced. There were, you know, some of even, you know, difficult ones, like the Staphylococcus, for example. It lowers cholesterol. And also some lotions with oregano oil has shown to reverse age spots. So that's another interesting use of the herbal, you know, benefits. You can use oregano fresh in salads, but oregano is really one of the herbs that the exception, where when the herb is dried, it becomes stronger flavor. And here I brought fresh and dried oregano, so you will be able also to taste it for yourself. And when it's dry, we put it in pizza, of course, but in every garlic and tomato dishes, we put oregano. And another traditional recipe that comes from Sicily, Salmoriglio, is based on oregano and lemon. Prezzemolo, we're almost at the end. So prezzemolo is parsley. The first thing that I wanted to point out that the Italian parsley is the one that has flat leaves, and you will find some here. Here you can find a lot of curled parsley, which is prettier. It's nicer to, you know, to dress your dish, but it's much less stronger, and the properties are not as strong as the flat one. It's native to the Mediterranean. The Greeks used it as a symbol of death, and it was used in the funeral in funerals. The Romans, even if they kept this thing in mind, they still use it in everyday cuisine. They use it as a bread freshener with soft cheese spreads, and also to make a green dye for their clothes. In the Middle Ages, they really didn't like parsley. For some reason, they really didn't like, and they said it was connected to evil. And you know, this is, there are interesting stories that I'm going to tell you just right now. The Romans. The Romans, they kept in mind that this was a funeral herb. So if they were talking about a third person saying, oh, he's just missing parsley, gli manca solo il prezzemolo, it means that that person didn't look too well. It was on the brink. So he's just missing parsley. And also, if they had very old guests or older guests, they would never serve parsley. It was considered to be a bad, you know, a bad thing to do. So that's quite interesting. And in the Middle Ages, parsley could not be planted by virgins. That was forbidden. And it was better if men would plant parsley, but only on Fridays. So that's also something else that I cannot figure out, but I thought it was interesting. Last thing that we say in Italy, to be like parsley means to be almost everywhere. So if a person is found in the social scene everywhere, it means that we can say, oh, come prezzemolo, she's like, or he's like parsley. Because actually we use parsley in a lot of dishes, so that's why. In terms of aromatic quality, therapeutic qualities, it has antioxidants, and this antioxidant here, theanogenin, is an antioxidant that helps the other antioxidants to work better. So it's kind of a boost for the antioxidants. It's very interesting that it's very rich in proteins. Up to 22% is protein and iron. So it's quite good for vegetarians, for example. It helps fight cancer. Well, it's a natural chemo preventative agent, let's say. And it's also a mind laxative, but as a contraindication in very high quantities, it shows to induce menstruation, stimulate contraction, and is considered to be an abortive plant with early pregnancy. So that's something that that we think. And it was actually used, in the past to induce that. As the basil, you can chop it and use it just at the end at the end of the dish. And some things, every Italian region has their own version of some sort of green sauce based on parsley. For example, in Lombardy, remoulada, that is used with lamb, ossobuco. And in Tuscany, we just call it salsa verde or green sauce, and it's used for boiled potatoes or boiled meats, for example. And it's very good with mushrooms. So a risotto with mushrooms, it wouldn't be the same if there wasn't a little bit of parsley just added at the end. So that's a basic thing. Rosmarino, the last two are my favorites. So rosmarino and I won't tell you the last one. So rosmarino. Rosemary is perennial and evergreen and native to the Mediterranean. And it likes dry and sunny places, and even the name Rosmarinum, Ros Maris, means the dew of the sea, so it means that it likes to stay close to the sea and close to the Mediterranean heat. The Romans used it both in weddings and funerals, so it was, for different purposes. In weddings, they would put sprigs in the bouquet as a sign of fidelity, but they would put also sprigs in the hand of the dead, and they would plant it close to the grave in sign of remembrance. So there were two different ways of use rosemary. In the Middle Ages, they used it a lot with sage, with toothpaste, tooth powders, and so forth. And as I told you before, it was burned also in hospitals with juniper berries just to ward off disease. It was considered to be a plant good for against nightmares, so you would put some sprigs under your pillow just to avoid having nightmares. So that's an interesting thing, and it's also good against ants or other insects. So I don't know, here in Canada maybe it's too cold. I don't know if you have these long lines of ants that sometimes they want to get in the house, and especially maybe in the countryside looking for food. So if you find a place where they actually enter and you put some sprigs of rosemary in it, they could just stop getting in the house, so you don't need to use any sprays or anything. But it actually works. I use it quite often when I go back to the farm. In terms of properties, it's again another chemopreventative agent. And it's another plant that is good for stress and heart disease. It lowers the cortisol levels as well. It improves concentration and memory, and it's considered to be an antidepressant. It's also, in some lotions, it's shown to protect from UV radiations, so that's another interesting thing. It is used in many, many different dishes, both salty and sweet. In Tuscany we have two desserts. They're not really sweet, but we call them sweets, which is pan di ramerino, which is the rosemary bread that we do for Easter, and the castagnaccio, which is based with chestnut flour and rosemary. Those are two things. It's very good for potatoes and bean soup, and if you are my mailing list or you want to be my mailing list, I'm going to send you the recipe of my own bean soup, my family's bean soup, which is based on, you can see here, rosemary and garlic. So that's pretty good. And another very interesting thing is that when you do barbecue, and you know that when you barbecue meat, when it's burnt, it creates some toxins which are carcinogenic, which are called HCAs. And to marinate meat with rosemary reduces a lot these HCAs. So that's a very interesting thing. If you marinate your meat, it doesn't work for vegetables. Do not, even if they're burnt, they do not create these toxins, but meat, meat does. And of course, the abbacchio in Rome is a lamb. It's a lamb-based, which I have it here, yeah, which is done with rosemary. The very last one, and then we're ready to eat and to taste. It's salvia. Salvia is considered to be a cure-all herb. There are more than 750 varieties of sage, but only the Salvia officinalis is the one that is used in the kitchen and for the therapeutic properties. It's perennial and native to the Mediterranean. The Romans used it again for, you know, different things, even to stop lactation when, you know, the baby was ready to get solid food. In the Middle Ages, it was considered to be an indispensable medicine, and I thought it was very interesting to know that, and I didn't know that, that in the 17th century, the Chinese that didn't have sage as a native plant, they thought it was so good that they traded sage, and they would pay 3-4 times the weight of sage into their finest tea. So there was this exchange, tea for sage, which I thought it was interesting. It has always been used as a teeth whitening, gum strengthener, and you can even, you know, take one leaf and just brush it on your teeth, and it will help with it. Many toothpastes are made with sage, in fact. And it's considered to be a cure-all herb, so much that there is a saying that goes back to the Roman time that says, why should a man die who grows sage in his garden? So that tells a lot of things. There are so many compounds in the sage, you know, I couldn't even, you know, put them so much in on the page. But some of the good things, the good properties of the sage is antiseptic, it's cooling, so it's good for fevers, for example. It helps with psoriasis, eczemas, it's antibiotic, antioxidants. It enhances energy, it has a lot of mineral and a lot of vitamins, so that's an interesting thing to know. And it's very good for nervous disorders, sharpens memory and concentration, and it prevents dementia, so it's really considered to be, you know, a great, and also, you know, the name Salvia means cure, so that's basically from Latin meaning cured or to save. Many things that we do with sage, there are, for example, in Tuscany fagioli, which are beans, and lucelletto, which is based on a tomato sauce. In fact, sage is good for starch and tomato sauce. It is good also with butter, with ravioli alla salvia. That's a basic thing that we do with butter, especially in northern Italy. Deep fried sage, if you haven't tried it, you really have to try it. It's the best of the best. And it has a grease-cutting action, so that means that it's good with game, sausages, and for example, saltimbocca alla romana, which are veal and ham, they always have a leaf of sage in it. So you were very patient tonight. Thank you for letting me finish. So that's